YouTube SEO tips and optimization for 2018 and beyond. It's coming up.
Brian G. Johnson.
Hey, it's me, Brian G. Welcome back. If you're new, stake your claim and amplify your message. Do that and you'll gain more subscribers. Click on the subscribe button as well as the bell notification and you'll be good to go. What's the best way to optimize my videos? Is it okay to change my metadata, titles and tags? And of course, how can I drive more views? These are the questions I get time and time again. Follow these four steps. And what you'll do is really make great decisions focused on your titles, your tags, and how you optimize. Let's jump in. And step number one, don't change your metadata, that's your titles and tags, for at least 30 days. Now the real answer is it's based on watch time. Everything on YouTube runs on watch time. There's no calendar or number of days, but as you're getting started, or if you're overwhelmed with the analytics and the whole watch time thing, just know you don't want to mess around and change things for the first 30 days of a video's release. Now we'll talk more about whether it's okay to change your metadata coming up in step number two. Step number two is understanding the risk versus reward when it comes to changing your metadata. I talked about this a bit in my last video on the YouTube suggested video algorithm. Over time, videos gain watch time and then they're pushed out and suggested in search locations on YouTube. Thus, you don't want to just be making changes. Instead, it's far better to have a planned out strategy based on how you title your videos. And what I want to share in step four is powerful because we identify one search term we want to rank for, and then we add to our video titles to incorporate more keyword phrases or a buzzworthy word. Stick around, this is going to get pretty good. Step number three is measuring your audience retention for the video you're considering changing the metadata around. So let's say you've got a video, it's not performing, and you're wondering, can I change the video title and do better? Well, possibly. What I like to do is, number one, again, never change the metadata before 30-day period or until your video has accumulated a lot of minutes watched. If that's the case, then you pay attention to audience retention on that particular video. And if it's pretty high, but you're not driving views and you think there's a better keyword phrase, then by all means, make the change to your video title and you'll be good to go. However, if your audience retention metrics are poor, then understand that that directly impacts just how much YouTube is gonna promote and push out the video in search and suggested locations. I'm really glad you made it this far. This is what you wanna do. Step number four, best YouTube SEO advice. Number one is begin by publishing your video and focusing on one core search term. Think about this, when someone's on YouTube and they're searching, they really can only be thinking about one thing at a time. They can only be thinking about one keyword phrase at a time. Thus, every video you publish should really be focused around that one idea or search term. For example, in fact, I'm gonna walk you through how I'm gonna upgrade this video title to drive more views throughout 2018. I went to YouTube and I typed in YouTube SEO and I saw a lot of different keyword phrases being displayed, primarily YouTube SEO tips. And I thought that looks pretty good, but it's probably competitive. I also noticed some search queries that included 2017 and 2018. And sure enough, I noticed the search term YouTube SEO tips 2018. By the way, by targeting this specific keyword phrase, it's gonna be easier to rank for that one keyword phrase, YouTube SEO tips 2018. And furthermore, my video title will still be incredibly optimized and relevant for the keyword phrase YouTube SEO tips. So I'm gonna publish my video and the only thing I'm gonna have in the video title is YouTube SEO tips 2018. And as I begin to rank and drive views with that video, yes, the video will accumulate watch time minutes, and if the retention is high, at that point, I'll add additional keyword phrases. What kind of keyword phrases will I add? Well, it's really based on other keyword phrases that people are searching for. How can you identify those? By simply going to YouTube, typing in the primary keyword phrase you're gonna begin with, you're going to publish with, and then pay attention if YouTube suggests any additional keyword phrases. Hang on. And this is how you can really drive more views easily. Just start off with one keyword phrase and add keyword phrases over time. And when I search for YouTube SEO tips, I see tips and tricks. I'll add that as a tag, by the way. YouTube SEO tips, how to optimize videos. And that's the keyword phrase I'll add to my title later. That is how to optimize videos, because this video really talks about that specific thing. Now you might be wondering, but Brian, you told us about like the buzzworthy trigger words and how we should add those to a video title. And that's a great way to move forward as well. In this example, we're really focused on SEO, but there's a trick. And the trick is to focus in this example on the SEO in the title, but then to add the trigger words or the buzzwords in the thumbnail. That way the users, the viewers, still see the trigger words. They are emotionally charged to click on your video, but you're targeting more keyword phrases. And this is exactly how you can drive more views easily on YouTube. Now check this out. How would you like to drive as much as 600, 700, even 800 views per day with just one video? Click on the video in the YouTube card right now to do just that. And if you wanna not just upload, but amplify your videos, click on the yellow B to the G icon below. You'll subscribe and I'll share the strategies, the tactics, the very simple methods that can allow you to successfully grow a channel. And yeah, you'll feed a poodle. I got two. You dig?